It was a swift operation cracking down on demonstrators. 900 members of the Venezuelan National Guard and police moved to clear four public squares that had been occupied by protesters in Caracas, the Venezuelan capital.
The National Guard showed up and finished the campsite. They came against us in a totally violent way.
243 demonstrators were detained. Government officials say they had no option but to act to ensure public safety.
Beyond the protest movement they intended to maintain at the site, they had become generators of violence in those sectors of the city. They had committed acts of terrorism.
Clashes between anti-government protesters and security forces have left 41 people dead and more than 800 injured since February, according to officials. The crisis is cause for concern beyond Venezuela.
The purpose of this hearing is to call attention to human rights violations in Venezuela.
In Washington, senators introduced a bill to impose sanctions on Venezuelan government officials who they claim are guilty of human rights violations.
There was a young man sodomized in Venezuela by government forces. There have been women that have been threatened. They've been threatened to rape them in Venezuela by government forces and those aligned with the government.
But Venezuelan President Nicolas Maduro called the bill an act of aggression against Venezuela and promised a bold response.
Si nos tocara cerrar todos los consulados.
If we have to close down consulates, if we have to close down the embassy in order to defend Venezuela, who is going to be affected?
Huh?
Those Venezuelans who live in the United States.
Venezuelan immigrants in Florida were not intimidated.
Some of the other sanctions is recognize Venezuela as a dictatorship, which it is, because right now we have high levels of censorship, we have scarcity, there's a medical crisis.
They traveled to Washington to support the bill, a bill they hope will bring about change in their country. Rafael Romo, CNN, Atlanta.